urgent question, and I call Megan Gallagher.
Apologies, Presiding Officer, to ask the Scottish Government what support is being provided to NHS Lanarkshire in light of reports that Wishaw Hospital A&E department was at full capacity at the weekend, with patients being transferred to Monklands Hospital.
Cabinet Secretary Humza Yousaf.
Firstly, it has always been part of Board's operational practice to work as a clinical network to manage demand by diverting patients between their hospitals where it's clinically safe to do so, minimising delays for patients. As you know, and every member knows, the health and care system is under extreme pressure due to the pandemic, and NHS Lanarkshire, like all health boards, is experiencing significant issues, including workforce challenges and high levels of delayed discharge. We recognise that some people aren't getting the service of care they or we indeed would expect, and of course I regret and apologise to anybody who suffered as a result of that. As members will know, we've invested an additional £300 million winter package of measures to support health and care services. Over and above this, to maximise capacity, we've also invested £10 million in two specialist programmes that aim to provide alternatives to admission and that our processes are right to ensure timely discharge. On top of this, the member will probably be aware that NHS Lanarkshire have been assigned 64 military medics to support the three acute setting sites. This task has recently been extended from the 11th of November until the 17th of December, which is welcomed by me and indeed the board. Me and my senior officials have been meeting regularly with the executive team at NHS Lanarkshire to agree immediate actions that will support improvements and minimise delay for patients. And I spoke to the Chief Executive of NHS Lanarkshire yesterday.
Megan Gallagher.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Cabinet Secretary, some patients who presented themselves at Wishaw General at the weekend were diverted to Monklands Hospital A&E department to receive treatment as there was a shortage of beds and high demand. The journey time between these two hospitals is 24 minutes. The Cabinet Secretary was aware of the concerns surrounding Wishaw General and other NHS Lanarkshire hospitals after they recently announced Code Black. So can I ask the Cabinet Secretary why no immediate intervention was made to prevent patients having to be diverted to another hospital nearly 10 miles away?
Cabinet Secretary.
Can I say that I disagree with the characterisation that no action was taken? I'll come to that in a second, but it should be said that any patient that is diverted to another hospital is done on the basis where a clinician has decided that it is safe to do so. But this idea that we haven't taken action, I'm afraid, is incorrect, and I can write to the member in quite a lot of detail in terms of the action that we've taken. In terms of the Code Black status, of course we don't want to see NHS Lanarkshire at the highest level of escalation. It's why we've invested £300 million in terms of a winter package. I've met with NHS Lanarkshire regularly. The key to that is to try to ensure that we can clinically discharge, where it's safe to do so, as many people out of the acute sites into the three hospital sites that the member knows about, into care as best and as quickly as we possibly can. But I'm more than happy to write to Megan Gallagher in a great amount of detail about the additional investment that has gone into NHS Lanarkshire. And my thanks to all of the staff, NHS and social care staff at NHS Lanarkshire, who are working so hard under very extreme pressure.
Megan Gallagher.
Target of 95% of patients being seen within 4 hours at A&E departments across all NHS localities. However, recent figures for NHS Lanarkshire show that only 61.8% of patients are being seen within the time frame. The Scottish Government has failed to get a grip of this crisis, and NHS Lanarkshire patients are paying the price. Therefore, will the Cabinet Secretary apologise to NHS staff and patients across the NHS Lanarkshire locality, and will he commit to getting a grip of this crisis?
Cabinet Secretary.
I will do, Presiding Officer, is thank our NHS staff, something that Megan Gallagher has not been able to do thus far, for their incredible work. In the midst of this global pandemic. And she talks about the 95% target. Yes, I, of course, acknowledge that we haven't met that target. And if she doesn't shout from a sedentary position and listens, she may get the answer to why that is the case. Because we are in the midst of a global pandemic, Ms. Gallagher. And yes, of course, we are not at the place we'd want to be. I can hear somebody shouting from a sedentary position. It would do well for the Conservatives and Mr. Kerr to listen to this answer, because it is incredibly important that we have seen, of course, 2 weeks of improvement. Yes, of course, NHS performance is not where I'd want it to be. But the fact of the matter is, Ms. Gallagher, and to the Conservative Party that are shouting from a sedentary position, we are still the best performing A&E department in the entire UK. And I don't say that And again, they would do well to listen. It was not because we are abdicating our responsibility. Our responsibility is over the Scottish NHS. But that surely demonstrates to members that this is a problem that health services right across the UK are facing. So my job is to ensure that the NHS boards, including NHS Lanarkshire, and our staff get the funding necessary to make the improvements, and we have seen improvements over the last 2 weeks, which haven't been acknowledged by Ms Gallagher, and of course to ensure that staff wellbeing is taken care of. And that's why I want to once again reiterate my thanks to our NHS and social care staff who are working incredibly hard in the midst of this pandemic.
Thank you. I call Claire Adamson.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Does the Cabinet Secretary agree that the unprecedented pressure on our NHS is attributable to the COVID-19 pandemic, and that this emphasises the importance of using every tool at our disposal to increase vaccine uptake and reduce case numbers? And does he also agree that the Conservatives' opposition to ongoing public health measures, including Ms Gallagher's own previous calls to align with England, sit at odds with their concern for the health service?
Cabinet Secretary.
Yes, I agree, and I could hear and can still hear the Conservative members shouting from a sedentary position, when of course Ms Adamson is absolutely correct. She is entirely correct that of course one of the pressures that we face, and not all of the pressures are attributed to COVID, but of course anybody that lives in the real world would understand of course that the pandemic has caused the biggest shock to our NHS in its 73-year existence. And for the fact that we have well over 750 patients with COVID in our hospitals that are taking up beds adds to that pressure. Now, controlling transmission of COVID, controlling infection, is clearly going to help alleviate some of that pressure as we go into the very depths of winter. And of course, we saw this afternoon when the First Minister was making her statement that the Conservatives' only contribution to this debate is to oppose every sensible measure this government looks to bring forward to control COVID, which would, of course, help to alleviate that pressure on NHS boards, including NHS Lanarkshire.
Paul O'Kane.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. This is an extremely serious situation, and I would want to also thank our NHS staff. But NHS Lanarkshire moved to Code Black on the 22nd of October, and that resulted in some cancer operations being cancelled for patients who were already experiencing unacceptably long delays. Some 3 weeks on since that Code Black was declared, these reports from Wishaw A&E Department clearly demonstrate that the Scottish Government has not dealt with the situation. So can I ask the Cabinet Secretary when he expects all elective surgeries, especially cancer procedures, to recommence?
Cabinet Secretary.
Just remind Paul O'Kane that we're still in the midst of a global pandemic. I can again hear him shouting from a sedentary position, but we are still in the midst of that global pandemic. And what I would say to him is that it's impossible for any government, I suspect, across the UK to set a target date of when all electives will be back on track. That's why we published the NHS recovery plan to increase capacity by 10%. That is backed by £1 billion investment over the course of the parliamentary term. But I would say to the member that it's not my decision, of course, to pause elective care. That is a decision that is taken by clinicians, quite rightly so. It's a decision that is taken by NHS health boards at their local health board area. And I know from speaking to NHS Lanarkshire, as I do every single week and as my officials do on effectively a daily basis, that these decisions are not taken lightly. And what I would say is that once Code Black, NHS Lanarkshire went into the highest level of escalation, I announced a number of additional measures and proposals with increased funding, and I'm happy to write to the member with details of what NHS Lanarkshire's what funding went directly to NHS Lanarkshire in that regard.
Julian Mackay.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I've been contacted by a constituent whose twin babies were born prematurely on the 21st of October at University Hospital, Wishaw, and I'd like to send our congratulations. They were then transferred to the Victoria Hospital in Kirkcaldy as the special care baby unit at Wishaw was closed due to staff shortages and a lack of available cots. It's now been 3 weeks and my constituent and his partner are both living out of suitcases, sleeping in the neonatal unit on a fold-down bed. Will the Cabinet Secretary look into this matter and ascertain whether alternative arrangements can be made to get them closer to home, if not back in Wishaw?
Cabinet Secretary.
Yes, of course I will, if Gillian Mackay can furnish me with the details. And again, the constituent's story that Ms Mackay rightly articulates here in this chamber is just, again, symptomatic of the pressures that we're facing at the moment. And NHS Lanarkshire is facing those pressures even more acute than other health boards right across the country. So we'll continue to not just invest, but I'll leave no stone unturned. That's why, of course, we were happy to facilitate that MACA request, the request to the military for further assistance for NHS Lanarkshire. But if Ms Mackay does furnish me with the details, I'll certainly raise that with the board and see what more can be done for the family involved.
Stephen Kerr.
Presiding officer, I really do think that the Cabinet Secretary has been incredibly patronising towards my colleague Megan Gallagher. She's asked very reasonable questions, and what she's gotten back is snippets from a ministerial briefing and sound bites about investment. She's actually asking the Cabinet Secretary about what he and his government have done to preempt the crisis that was declared in Lanarkshire, in NHS Lanarkshire. And what he's given us back is politics. Can he tell us, can he give us a sample of this extensive and exhaustive list of things he's done that he couldn't tell us one thing of a few minutes ago?
Cabinet Secretary.
That was barely worth listening to, I have to say, Presiding Officer. This is a serious issue. This is a serious issue that deserves far more than Stephen Kerr's bluff and Stephen Kerr's bluster in terms of the action we've taken.
Can I just ask Cabinet Secretary, just for a moment, can I just remind all members who will be well-versed in the Code of Conduct that we have a duty to treat one another with courtesy and respect at all times? Thank you. Cabinet Secretary.
In terms of the action we've taken, we have invested £20 million additional funding into the Scottish Ambulance Service. In fact, £20 million before the announcement I made in September, taking the additional resource for the Scottish Ambulance Service to more than to £40 million, a £300 million winter package, which again I'm happy to give him details of. The First Minister announced £482 million recently in terms of helping with COVID pressures. I announced in July an additional £12 million. Last week I announced an additional £10 million. The week before that I announced an additional £10 million as well. If the member wants me to keep going, I can tell him a number of actions. And then on top of that, of course, he says practical things. He doesn't think money or investment, of course, is practical. But that investment is helping our NHS boards, including NHS Lanarkshire.
Monica Lennon.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Constituents in Lanarkshire have told me that they're willing to travel to other health boards. When I asked the board about this on Friday, I was told apart from the Golden Jubilee for a small number of cases, there is no capacity in other health boards. Since then, I've been told that other health boards have approached Lanarkshire, which is in Code Black, asking Lanarkshire for help. Are there any other health boards close to Code Black, and when can we expect mutual aid to become available? Is there any spare capacity at all in our health system?
Cabinet Secretary.
And so there's no other health board at the moment that is going to raise its escalation level to the highest level of escalation black, which NHS Lanarkshire is on. But of course, that is a situation that is reviewed daily, weekly, and in fact, actually is reviewed hourly, I suspect, by health boards, given the extreme pressures that they are under. In terms of mutual aid, it's not uncommon for health boards to reach out to other health boards for mutual aid. I know a number of health boards have done that depending on the different services. I was talking to NHS Tayside yesterday, who I understand are speaking to other health boards about potential mutual aid for some of their breast cancer services, for example. In terms of elective surgery, of course, if there is at all any theatre capacity and there are teams that can be brought together from different health boards, then we're looking extensively to see how we can maximise that opportunity. But the NHS Golden Jubilee is helping health boards right across the country, including NHS Lanarkshire, with some elective surgeries.
Thank you. That concludes the urgent question. The next item of business is a committee announcement, and I call Siobhan Brown, convener of the COVID-19 Recovery Committee, to make an announcement on their upcoming debate, COVID-19, Preparing for Winter and Priorities for Recovery.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I wish to inform the Chamber that the COVID-19 Recovery Committee will be initiating a debate on COVID-19, Preparing for Winter and Priorities for Recovery. The debate will be held on Thursday, the 2nd of December, and we're keen for as many committees to take part as possible. We feel the timing is right to hold this debate. The committee has been following the Scottish Government's response to COVID closely, and we're aware that case numbers remain stubbornly high. Scottish ministers and others have warned that we face a very challenging winter ahead, and although we're all very keen for this to be over, we feel we can't take our eyes off the ball. For this reason, the committee has decided to examine the ongoing use of baseline measures to respond to COVID-19. The Scottish Government's strategic framework, which was updated just today, states that the aim of these measures is to suppress the virus to a level consistent with alleviating its harms while we recover and rebuild for a better future. The committee will be keen to highlight the evidence that we've heard on the use of these measures, as we know that Scotland's ongoing response to COVID-19 is an issue that concerns all members. The committee is also keen to hear what work other committees have been doing in relation to COVID-19. We want them to use this debate to highlight the issues that they feel this Parliament should be prioritising for recovery. The COVID-19 Recovery Committee hopes to turn its focus to recovery in the new year and to add value to the important work being led by other committees. Presiding Officer, I hope many committees will take part in this debate, and I encourage as many members as possible to please get involved. Thank you.
Thank you. The next item of business is consideration of Parliamentary Bureau Motion 2150 on suspension and variation of standing orders. And I ask George Adam, on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau, to move the motion.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I'm moved.
Thank you, Minister. The question on this motion will be put at decision time. And there are four questions to be put as a result of today's business. The first is that Amendment 2127.1, in the name of Liz Smith, which seeks to amend Motion 2127 in the name of Kate Forbes on celebrating the first anniversary of the Scottish National Investment Bank, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The amendment is therefore agreed. The next question is that Amendment 2127.2, in the name of Daniel Johnson, which seeks to amend Motion 2127 in the name of Kate Forbes on celebrating the first anniversary of the Scottish National Investment Bank, be agreed. Are we all agreed?
No.
The Parliament is not agreed, and there will be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.